This video is dedicated for the memory of Dr. Muhammad Salah Al-Johri and Dr. Mustafa Al-Qattan.
Hello and welcome to Dentistry 101, your source for online dental education. We hope that you enjoy.
The temporomandibular joint is a unique joint between the lower jaw and the skull. It is found between the fossa and the articular eminence, and it allows for a smooth movement between the lower jaw and the skull because it contains a flexible disc which is made from fibrocartilage. At first, the movement is pure rotation, then the condyle of the lower jaw slides forward in a translatory movement which could be felt by placing the finger in front of the ear while opening your mouth. Any problem in the temporomandibular joint is referred to as a temporomandibular disorder or TMD. The definition of the temporomandibular disorder is not specific. Any pain during the rest or the function of the temporomandibular joint can be considered TMD. We could even consider having mandibular dysfunction during moving of the lower jaw, such as jaw deviation or locking or chewing difficulties. We could consider all of these factors as temporomandibular disorders. The cause of the temporomandibular disorders is not specific. TMDs happen more in women than in men. The disc of the TMJ was found to have estrogen receptors. We could classify the TMJ disorders or the TMDs into problems associated with the muscles of mastication, problems inside of the joint, or systemic diseases. Like all problems which could happen in the muscles of the body, the muscles of mastication, which are primarily responsible for movement of the lower jaw and the TMJ, could have a problem. The two most important muscles of mastication which are responsible for moving the TMJ are the masseter and the temporalis muscles. Some people experience pain while opening their mouth and point to the area above the ear where the temporalis muscle is situated, or to the side of the jaw where the masseter muscle is situated. Because of this, some patients are not even able to open their mouth properly. TMDs could also be caused by problems inside of the joint. Problems inside of the joint could happen from extrinsic factors such as trauma, or could be caused by the disc dysfunction. The disc dysfunction is the most common cause for TMDs inside of the joint. Disc disorders happen because of the muscles and ligaments pulling the disc to an abnormal position. The most common type of disc dysfunction is the anterior disc displacement, through which the muscles and the ligaments pull the disc to a forward position without reduction in relation to the condyle, and the disc could stay in this position for hours and prevent the patient from completely opening his mouth. For the condyle to be able to move forward, it needs to jump forward between the disc and the articular eminence, producing a click sound. This could be associated with severe pain. When patients have anterior disc displacement and the disc does not go back, it becomes a problem because they are not able to open their mouth properly and could experience pain. However, clicking without pain or dysfunction is considered to be an anterior disc displacement with reduction, which means that the disc reduces to its normal position, a phenomena called benign clicking. During the benign clicking, when the disc moves forward slightly, the condyle is able to pass the posterior part of the disc during opening to get to the middle of the disc. The sound happens because of the condylar head passing the back part of the disc. It should be emphasized that this phenomena is completely normal. Many people who experience benign clicking without any other symptoms, they feel that they have a problem or a TMJ disorder. People having benign clicking need to be educated and assured that with time, the clicking will decrease. Benign clicking was considered to be a temporomandibular disorder, and extreme treatments such as surgeries were done. And after the surgery, most of the patients were unable to function their mouth or open it. In the same time, people who were not treated and left with benign clicking lived a normal life without having any problems. Patients complaining from clicking without any pain or dysfunction need to be educated that this is something normal and nothing should be done. Some dentists or oral surgeons ask the patients to do x-rays or CBCT images to view the condyle properly. It should be emphasized that any changes in the anatomy of the condyle is not diagnostic. Some people think that a change in the joint shape or the shape of the condyle is considered to be a problem. However, it is normal bone remodeling which happens. Some people consider having a round condylar head to be healthy, and if the condyle head was flat in the x-ray,
X-ray, it indicates that there is a problem in the temporomandibular joint. This is a false assumption because many people having temporomandibular disorders or problems in the TMJ have normal X-rays, and at the same time, people not complaining from temporomandibular disorders could have a flat-shaped condyle. We do not care about the shape of the condyle. As long as the white outline of the condyle is found in the X-ray, it is considered to be healthy and normal. As long as there is no pain or restriction in the jaw movement, any change in the shape of the condyle of the X-ray or even having clicking sounds is not considered as a TMD. There is another condition in which the temporomandibular joint is in front of the eminence and is not able to move back, preventing the ability of making the patient to close his mouth. This condition is called open lock or open dislocation or subluxation. This happens because the muscles of mastication keep on pulling the joint in a forward position. During dental treatment, patients could experience an open lock after some time of mouth opening, and they are unable to close their mouth because of the excessive muscle pull. The dentist must be able to guide the mandible properly to its position. This is done by protecting both thumbs with cotton and placing both thumbs on the occlusal surface of the lower teeth. Push one side of the mandible downward and pull the other side upwards while rotating the mandible posteriorly. This will cause the jaw to unlock and the patient will be able to close his mouth again. The dental treatment should be stopped and continued when the patient gets better. Concerning the systemic diseases, any systemic condition which affects the joints of the body will affect the temporomandibular joint. Conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis or arthritis in general could cause temporomandibular disorders. Itis means inflammation and arth means joints. Arthritis simply means joint inflammation of the body. And treating the systemic cause of the osteoarthritis will treat the temporomandibular disorder. The temporomandibular joint has an advantage over the other joints of the body. It could repair because the temporomandibular joint is made from fibrocartilage, which has blood supply and could regenerate and function properly again. Arthritis of the TMJ could be diagnosed by cone beam CTs. There will be a dark shadow in the outer outline of the temporomandibular joint. If there is no patient complaint, nothing should be done. As stated before, to diagnose a temporomandibular disorder, the patient should complain either from pain or from a problem during mandibular movements. For a very long time, most of the people believed that having malocclusions where the teeth are not properly aligned is one of the major causes for temporomandibular disorders. Recent studies have shown that there is no evidence to suggest that having a bad bite is a cause of the temporomandibular disorders. Microtrauma, which could cause joint inflammation by the muscles, such as having a recent filling or having a high filling, will increase the pressure on this side of the TMJ, causing the joint pain. However, this joint pain is not permanent, and removing of the causative factor will remove the temporomandibular pain. Loading of the temporomandibular joint by using force on the teeth, such as patients who grind their teeth or clench their teeth or people who eat hard foods, are more prone to have temporomandibular pain. People who grind their teeth or bite or clench on their teeth or have bruxism or even eat hard foods, not all of them develop temporomandibular disorders, while others develop temporomandibular disorders without having these problems. So what is the definitive cause or the risk factor? Until now, the determining factor is not known. All of the recent studies are concerned about the joint adaptability. The temporomandibular disorders are believed to be a multifactorial disease, which is affected by the load, the genetics, body conditions, the resilience of the person, and the body adaptation. The resilience of the individual involves the way the person thinks when dealing with the temporomandibular disease. It was found out that the TMJ pain is amplified by the emotional pain and the mental health of the individuals. Concerning the body adaptation, some people who have factors which could cause TMJ pain do not develop temporomandibular disorders because their TMJ is able to adapt with these harmful situations. Others have a body which could not adapt to this situation, and the joints could not regenerate. Concerning the treatment of the temporomandibular disorders, in the past, most of the problems were treated with temporomandibular surgery. This surgery had very bad results, starting from having a temporomandibular joint with limited movements to the complete inability of the patient to move his mouth. The use of the surgery in the temporomandibular disorder treatment became very low and it is rarely indicated. The common treatment used is prescribing NSAIDs and muscle relaxants while instructing the patient to apply heat on the joints for 10 to 15 minutes 3 times every day. Recently, because of the discovery of the resilience factor and the effect of the emotional pain, pain counseling or psychological counseling became the first line of treatment for people having chronic temporomandibular disorders. Physical therapy became one of the most important ways to eliminate or decrease the temporomandibular disorders. Using warm heat 10 to 15 minutes 3 times every day could decrease the pain. Many dentists prescribe the splint or the night guard as a first line of treatment for the temporomandibular disorders. The idea of the night guard is that it distributes the occlusal forces on all of the teeth to decrease the effect on the temporomandibular joint when sleeping. Some of the people experience improvement and decline of the temporomandibular pain. Others do not feel any difference, and some of the patients experience more pain. Dentists need to prescribe the night guard or the splint only when the patients complain that the pain is increased after waking up from sleep. Using a hard type of night guard or a soft type of night guard will not differ. It is recommended to use a thick type of night guard of 2 mm so that it could last for a longer time. If the patient wears the night guard for more than 24 hours, the dental occlusion of the patient will start to change. Some studies have found that the effect of the night guard is a placebo effect. When the patient feels that he has something to treat his problem, his emotional pain will be decreased and he will start to have a positive feeling, which will improve his condition. The night guard could act as a positive psychological treatment for the temporomandibular disorders. After fabricating the splint or the night guard for the patient, the dentist must follow up with the patient to see if it is making the patient comfortable or not. If the patient complains that the night guard is making him uncomfortable, the dentist must instruct the patient to stop wearing the night guard. The night guard must cover the occlusal surfaces of all of the teeth evenly. The dentist must make sure that the night guard has an even contact on both sides with an articulating paper before giving the patient the night guard. People who have extracted many posterior teeth are prone to have temporomandibular disorders because of the excessive muscle pull, which is normally prevented by the presence of teeth. And at the same time, people who have bruxism or clenching and there is an excessive wear on their posterior teeth, overclosing of the mandible will cause excessive muscle pull. Restoring the vertical dimension of occlusion, either with composite or dental crowns, is a must. Any patient having temporomandibular disorders should have a soft diet and not eat hard foods. Muscle relaxants like myofine are indicated during acute temporomandibular disorder pain to decrease the action of the muscles. Botox injections decrease the temporomandibular pain in some of the patients, because Botox decreases the action of the muscle on the temporomandibular joint and hence decreases the pain felt. The effect of the Botox injection could last an average of 6 months before the need to re-inject again. People experiencing temporomandibular pain related to the muscles of mastication, the temporalis or the masseter, are recommended to perform muscle massage using different movements, specifically the circular movements using the hands on the muscles. The muscles could be felt by the patient when opening their jaw. Massaging these muscles 3 to 4 times every day will decrease the pain. Reducing the stress levels improves the condition of the temporomandibular disorders. To summarize, the temporomandibular disorders need to be diagnosed by signs and symptoms from the patients. People having benign clicking need to be educated and assured that with time, the clicking will decrease. The presence of pain or abnormal functioning diagnoses the presence of a problem in the TMJ. If the patient has a loss in vertical dimension, it needs to be raised. If the patient has missing multiple posterior teeth, they need to be restored. If the patient has pain specifically after waking up, an eye guard should be fabricated. If the patient eats hard foods, he should stop. Patients should start performing physical therapy and jaw exercises. Pain counseling could help many people. Using warm heat 10 to 15 minutes 3 times every day could decrease the pain. These treatments could be complemented by the use of NSAIDs and muscle relaxants in acute conditions, and Botox injections could be helpful in some of the patients. And this brings an end to our video temporomandibular joint 101. If you like the video, please hit like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.